somebody, we can feel somebody give us a touch, give us a hug, give us a word of encouragement. Hearing that, that's great that God does that for us. But He wants us to know that because of what Christ did for us, we don't have to make an appointment to go and sit in the throne room. We also, because of what He's done for us, we don't have to crawl into the throne room of heaven and hope that He doesn't notice us, because if He notices us, He's going to say, "What are you doing here?" He looks at us and goes, "Man, come on. No, come on. Come on. It's okay. I want you to come be with me." If Christians, I'm convinced, if we, including myself, if we could live with those two things in mind, that I'm never ever alone, that I can always go into His presence, always, and that I'm a child of the King, how is it going to impact the decisions I make this week? How is it going to impact the thoughts that I have this week? How is it going to impact when the enemy throws this particular bunch of junk at me? I get to go, "Wait a minute, wait. That's what you want me to think, but reality is, I'm a child of the King. My wardrobe, kingly stuff." The name of Jesus is a currency that we carry with us. And it's an amazing thing. It's a currency that we can't run out of. Look, I'm going to go over and tell this person about Jesus. Oh, no. I'm going to be short. I'm going to run out of Jesus. Nope. I'm going to go over there and tell. The more we talk about Jesus, the more we have to talk about Jesus. And that is what He wants us to do. Next, I do encourage you this week to read through John 17, if you would. And next Sunday, we're gonna go through that, and we're going to really look at Jesus' high priestly prayer. I love that. When you stop and think high priestly prayer, though, it kind of almost makes it sound like, you know, I got to wear our suit and tie, which, trust me, no suit and tie necessary. It's a lot warmer than high priestly prayer sounds. It's really going to be awesome. So let's pray, and then we'll be dismissed to fellowship. God, I thank You so much for everybody who's here today. And I know that we still have folks visiting, and I so appreciate that. And we have folks who are visiting somewhere else and on vacation and traveling and just home because they need a day of rest. And God, I pray that You would bless them with Your presence, that they would know that they are the children of the Most High God, and that they are never, ever alone. God, I pray that You would walk through this week with us, Holy Spirit, that You would teach us this week more about being a dependent child than an independent adult. That we would become more dependent on You this week and less dependent on ourselves. Now, Father God, I do believe that because of the work of the Holy Spirit, we have power, we have authority, we can call forth healing, we can call forth blessing so that we can bless other people, we can call forth good when the enemy means it to be evil, we can call forth all of that stuff because of who we are, and I pray, Father, that this week we will use the authority that You have given us, we will use the power that You have given us, because we want the world to see that the Savior is alive and well, that our Father God is active and is paying attention and is an active love relationship with us, and that the Holy Spirit that lives inside of us is strong and powerful and loving. Help us to live this week as we are truly, truly, truly transformed by the renewing of our minds through the Holy Spirit in Christ Jesus at the gift of the Father. Bless us now as we go into fellowship. In Jesus' name, amen. This morning, if you have any needs for me or I can pray for you in any way, I'm going to be down here around the front. Otherwise, I want to dismiss you to have some fellowship time. Thank you.
won't run, I will stay, I'm not leaving you. I know there's friction here, the struggle makes us new. I wish you never thought you had to go.